Hi again. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Today I'm going to talk about pro forma balance sheet. Even though I have produced a video on pro forma balance sheet, I believe my videos on pro forma balance sheet is not satisfactory. And it's a bit confusing because the explanation on the textbook is much more complicated than what you usually come across during tests or in the final exam. Okay, I think everybody knows how a balance sheet looks like. Yeah, this is a typical balance sheet. So a typical balance sheet will have. So this is ABC company balance sheet as at 31st December, let's say 2018. And then we have assets. And then we have liabilities plus equity. Okay, we have assets and liabilities and plus equity, and on the asset side, we have current assets and we also have fixed assets. Okay, so we have current assets and fixed assets. Typical items on current assets such as cash, marketable securities, account receivables, and inventories. So we have. These are the typical items on the balance sheet. So if you add up this figure, you will get total current assets. And fixed assets, we usually have plant and equipment. And usually plant and equipment, and sometimes the figure is given on gross plant and equipment, sometimes is net. If you are given a gross plant and equipment, you have to deduct the depreciation. If the number is already in net plant and equipment, there's no need for you to deduct depreciation because it's already taken care of. So you add up total assets and total current assets and fixed asset, you get total assets. Okay. On the liabilities and equity side, we have current liabilities. What are usually items and current liabilities, like accounts payable, and then we have notes payable, and we have things like accruals, and other current liabilities. Okay, when you add up all these things, you get total current liabilities. Current liabilities. Okay. And then we have long-term liabilities. Here we have long-term liabilities. And then we have equity. Equity usually consists of common stock, and retain earnings. Common stock and retain earnings. So we have liabilities and equity side. So when you add liabilities, current liabilities and long-term liabilities and equity, you have total liabilities plus equity. Liabilities plus equity. Okay, a balance sheet must have a balanced amount of assets and liabilities plus equity. So this figure and this figure should be of the same amount. Okay, now back to our discussion on pro forma balance sheet. Okay, what is actually a pro forma balance sheet? A pro forma balance sheet is a balance sheet that that we prepare for next period of time, or based on our certain forecast. Of course, there are many ways of constructing a balance sheet or pro forma balance sheet, but for the purpose of this class, we will only discuss one one technique of preparing pro forma balance sheet. This technique is called percent of sales method, percentage of sales method. Okay, the percentage of sales method is based on the on certain assumption. Yeah, we have to identify which of the items will increase with the increase in sales. Some of the balance sheet items are assumed to be increased with the same percentage of increase in sales. Let's say if sales increase by 5% or 5%, so the items, the some of the items will also increase proportionately. It will also increase by 5%. Not all items in the balance sheet will increase. Some of the items will remain at the same level. So how do we identify which of the items will increase and which of the items will remain constant? Okay. So there are certain assumptions that we have to make. Okay, the first assumption is that on current assets. Okay, our assumption is all current assets will increase except for marketable securities. Okay, so that is the first assumption. On the current asset, on the asset side, it is assumed that with the increase in sales, all items on the current assets will increase except for marketable security. So you might ask, why marketable security does not change with an increase in sales? We will come back into that later on, but as of now, it's sufficient for me to say that some of the items that automatically increase with the increase in sales is called spontaneous items, which it will spontaneously increase with the increase in sales. Some of the items that remain unchanged is a discretionary item. Discretionary item. So marketable securities is considered as discretionary item. However, this assumption might not hold, might not be used by all textbooks. Some textbooks will also increase the marketable securities proportionately with the increase in sales. Okay, so now this part is clear. Everything will increase with the same proportion with the increase in sales except for marketable securities. Okay, what about fixed assets? Okay, for fixed assets,
fixed assets, we have two situations. One, if the firm is currently operating at full capacity, so there are two situations here. One is operating at full capacity. Full capacity, and the other one will be operating at below capacity. Okay, if the firm is currently operating at full capacity, any increase in sales will automatically will increase the fixed assets proportionately. It means that if the sales increase by, let's say, 10%, the fixed assets will also increase by the same percentage, 10%. Okay. However, if the firm is operating at below capacity, any increase in sales will not change the fixed assets value. Will not change the fixed assets. So that you have to keep in mind. Okay. You might ask, how do we know whether the firm is operating at full capacity or below capacity? It all depends, or usually it will be stated in the question. So you just follow whether the question states that the firm is operating at full capacity or below capacity. However, sometimes the question does not say anything about the firm capacity. So in this case, we have to make some assumptions. Okay. Then we take a look at the liabilities and equity side. Okay, on the liabilities and equity side, okay, so first we focus our attention on the current liabilities. Okay, our assumption is that all current liabilities will increase with the increase in sales, except for notes payable. Notes payable will remain unchanged or remain constant. Okay, so all current liability will increase except for notes payable. Okay, notes payable will remain constant or unchanged. Why is this so? I will explain to you. The assumption is that other items in the balance sheet, other items in the liability sector of the balance sheet, are spontaneous items, accounts payable, accruals. So it will increase with the increase in sales. However, notes payable is considered as a discretionary item. It means that if you were to increase the notes payable, it has to be done consciously. Of course, this simple rule, you have to simply memorize it, because in the exam, you simply apply whatever assumption that we hold. Okay, what about this long-term liabilities and the equity part? Okay, for long-term liabilities, it will remain constant. Yeah, long-term liabilities, there is no changes, so you just maintain the figure. Okay, now we go to equity. Equity part, usually the common stock does not change unless stated otherwise. Otherwise, if there's no mention about the increase in common stock, so it is assumed that the common stock will remain constant. However, retained earnings is a bit complicated. Yeah, so we need to discuss further on retained earnings. Okay, let me stop for a while.